गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स. सो टुडे वी विल डू चैप्टर नंबर फर्स्ट ऑफ क्लास सेवेंथ, अ हीरो. सो लेट्स स्टार्ट द क्लास. बेसिकली दिस चैप्टर इज रिटन बाय एन इंडियन राइटर, आर के नारायण, हु इज़ नॉट ओनली अ राइटर बट अ नॉवलिस्ट एंड अ शॉर्ट स्टोरी राइटर. सो इन दिस चैप्टर ही हैज़ ब्यूटिफुली पोर्ट्रेट द चाइल्ड एंड इज साइकोलॉजी. द नेम ऑफ द बॉय इज स्वामी, हु इज़ अ वेरी टिमिड बॉय एंड अफ्रेड ऑफ हिज ड्रीम्स एंड घोस्ट. टू सेव हिमसेल्फ फ्रॉम फियर ही यूज टू स्लीप विद हिज ग्रैंड मदर ड्यूरिंग द नाइट. हिज फादर वॉन्ट्स हिम टू ग्रो अप एंड फेस लाइफ चैलेंजेस करेजियसली. स्वामीज फादर फोर्सेज हिम टू स्लीप इन हिज ऑफिस अलोन. When Swami sleeps in his father's office, he has nightmares about the ghost and wake up with the start. At the same time, Swami spots an intruder breaking into the office. Mistaking him for the ghost, Swami grabs the intruder's leg, bites his ankle and yells for help. The family members catch the thief and handed him over to the police. Even the police appreciates Swami and want him to join the police force, but Swami wants to work as an engine driver or bus conductor. Appreciation showers on him. Swami shows his bravery and gets rid of fear, and humor and irony runs throughout the story. So this was the brief story that I have explained. So let's talk the story in detail. For Swami, events took an unexpected turn. Father looked over the newspaper he was reading under the hall lamp and said, "Swami, listen to this. News is to hand of the bravery of a village lad who, while returning home by the jungle path, came face to face with a tiger." The paragraph described the fight the boy had with the tiger and his flight up a tree, where he stayed for a half a day till some people came that way and saved him. So the story opens with a lively dialogue between the son and the father. The conversation between the father and the son has been presented in a very delightful manner. His father reads an article about the bravery shown by an 8-year-old boy who came face to face with the tiger and his flight up a tree, where he stayed for a half a day on the tree and people came that way, killed the tiger and rescued the boy. After reading it through, father looked at Swami fixedly and asked, "What do you say to that?" So now, after all this, Swami questions his father, "How could a boy fight a tiger?" Father answers that human can do anything with courage. Courage is everything. Strength and age are not important. So, if we see at the book, there was a dialogue that is very important, that fathers need. A man may have the strength of an elephant and yet to be coward, whereas another may have the strength of a straw. But if he has courage, he can do anything. Courage is everything. Strength and age are not important. So Swami's father was trying to make him understand that if you have courage, strength and age are really not important. Swami's father feels that Swami should do something similar. His father then challenges, or rather forces him, to sleep in his office. As we see, leave alone strength. Can you prove have a courage? Let me see if you can sleep alone tonight in my office room. So he challenged his son to sleep in the office room alone. Though Swami has agreed to sleep in the father's office, it is clear that he is afraid. But Swami's father thinks that Swami needs to grow up and sleep alone without the comfort of sleeping by his grandmother's side. Swami's father is not only hoping that he is able to teach Swami a lesson about growing up, but he may also be hoping that Swami will develop the independence that he thinks Swami should have. A frightful proposition, Swami thought. He had always slept beside his granny in the passage, and any change in the arrangement kept him trembling and awake all night. He hoped at first that his father was only joking. He mumbled weakly, "Yes," and tried to change the subject. He said very loudly with a great deal of enthusiasm, "We are going to admit even elders in our cricket club hereafter. We are buying brand new bats and balls. Our captain has asked me to tell you." So father replied, "We'll see about it later." Father cut it, "You must sleep alone hereafter." Swami realized that the matter has gone beyond his control. From a challenge, it had become a plain command. He knew his father's tenacity at such moment. "From the first month of next, I'll sleep alone, father. No, you must do it now. It is disgraceful sleeping beside granny or mother like a baby, father replied. You are in the second form and I do not all like the way you are being brought up, he said and looked at his wife who was rocking the cradle. After all this, his wife replied, why do you look at me while you say it? I hardly know anything about the boy. No, I don't mean you, father said. So with all these conversation, the father was looking at his wife and he was saying all the things, but his mother replied that I hardly knew anything about the boy. So don't you just dare to blame me. If you mean that your mother is spoiling him, tell her so and don't look at me, she said and turned away. So now she just turned away the thing to pointing his Swami's grandmother and he just started doing her own work. Swami's heart beat faster as father rolls up his bed and takes Swami to the office to sleep there. Swami stirs and grows as if he is in sleep. He remembers all the stories of devils and ghosts he has heard in his entire life. Recalls the devil in the banyan tree at his street end, Munisami's father who spat out blood when ghost slapped his cheek, ticking of the clock, rustle of the trees, snoring sounds and some vague night insects humming frightened Swami. He hurriedly gets up and spread his bed under the bench. Crouches there, dreamt of a tiger chasing desperately trying to escape, but his feet would not move. Swami groans in despair. He opens his eyes but himself lonely. He sweats with fright. He feels something is moving towards the bench. In horror, thought that his end has approached. Swami jumps as it hugs it with all his might. He starts biting person. Ayo, something has bitten me, comes a loud cry followed by a heavy tumbling and falling amidst furniture. People in the house rushed to office room and all of the three of them fell on the burglar who lay the furniture with a bleeding ankle. They catch him and handed him over to the police. So in this manner, Swami catches the intruder who entered into their home unknowingly. After all this, he got appreciated by his family and by the members of the village. Swami's action elevates him to the status of a hero. His classmates look at him with respect and teachers pat his back. He is happy enough to take the adulation he receives from others. The police are grateful to him for helping them to catch the most notorious housebreakers of the district. The police want him to join the police force, but Swami wants to work with an engineer, driver or bus conductor. Though Swami shows his bravery and get rid of fear, he prefers to sleep by his grandmother still. The day when Swami's father returned home at night ironically comments, no wonder he wants to be asleep before I should return home. Clever boy, huh? Mother, having lost her temper, replies, you let him sleep wherever he likes. You need not to risk his life again. Swami, following the conversation from under the blanket, feels tremendously relieved to hear that his father is giving up him. So, Swami's family is an excellent representation of a typical Indian family packed with humor. The reader is entertained highly by the utilization of reader reflection by the characters Swami, his father, his mother and grandmother depicted by the writer R.K. Narayan. He entertains the reader by the use of characterized family childish humor and elements of literary and language devices, which was the twist of irony. R.K. Narayan puts a moral through the story that courage is everything. Strength and age is really not important, and with that courage, one can do anything courageously. Swami questions his father, how can a boy fight with a tiger? Father replied that a human can do anything with the courage. He further says that courage is everything, strength and age are not important. So from all this chapter, we came to know that with the courage and strength, we can do anything and we can make anything impossible possible thing. So this is all about the chapter. I hope everything is clear to you. Thank you for listening. Goodbye.